Now this car actually is a aftermath of a project that we had earlier, which we call the tandem project. And in California, I don't know about here so much, but in California, we have a lot of cars on the road with one driver, right? Or two people, but normally one person. So in California, what we said is we wanted to design a car that could actually take up a little bit of space, but be very, very safe, and possibly even be able to drive in the carpool lane. So we designed products around a tandem design, which is front and rear. Very narrow car, front and rear driver. And we actually made these cars, and we had a running prototype. And some of you journalists may have had an experience of driving them in California. But that was too, it was just a little too out there. A little too out there, right? So we said we have to come back to reality, but we wanted some of the sequences to remain important, and that was the size. We want the car to be small enough and yet powerful enough, okay? So this car is 1650 wide, and that's pretty narrow for a production car. But it's very strong, and it has a lot of substance on the side of the car for side impact. And what we wanted to do then is we wanted to put two people close together in the car, as close as we could go. We made a number of bucks to see just how close we could sit to one another, because all of you, when you sit in the car, you don't want to be shoulder to shoulder. So we had to really define just how close is close. And when you put those people close together, what do you lose? Well, we lose the center stack, so we have to do something else, right? And then we said we can't just have a sports car with two seats. It's not Volvo. We have to add something else. And we said that children are very important in our lives, right? So we said, let's make a back seat for one person, one adult, one good-sized adult, or two children. And can we still have a sporty car? This car was never meant to be a commuter car. We don't want this to be a commuter. We want it to be a sporty car. Good-sized tires and wheels, good balance. So if you have a choice to drive a car in your family, this is the one you want. You know, you're going to want this car.
You're going to pop up for the carpool?
Yes, that's right. That's right. Like we said before, this car is about safety. We said if we build a small car, Volvo has to have it as safe as a Ford F-150 pickup or an S80. So we designed this car to take the same crash as those cars. And one way we did it is we took the occupancy area inside. And the front seats, the back seat, the dash, the steering wheel, they all move forward 200 millimeters on impact. So you have this ride-down effect. We have a patent on this. And that's how we sustain this safety feature. And if we could put that in all of our Volvo cars, you can imagine what would happen. Okay? This is becoming old hat to us now, and it's normal. Also in the back, if you have a rear-end collision, this car, the whole cradle inside moves 75 millimeters. So you have this freedom, this cage, very powerful cage inside that is moving on impact. And we think that's really nice. And also, because we have only one door on the side, and we chose to have one door because some of our other products had four doors, we chose one door because you have a stronger shell that way. And it's all reinforced around the opening of that door. Okay. So when you get in the car, and we'll demonstrate this if the electricity is working, as the compartment comes forward, you can actually get in the back seat quite easily. Okay. We have something unique on our cars. It's called the center stack, right? It's on the S40, and it's a floating center stack. We're going to be having that in all of our cars. This one, we have a floating instrument panel. It goes horizontally, and that moves in and out. The ducting on the VCC that you saw there, the air ducting, you don't see any air ducts. That's because air comes in from areas that are hidden. And you have this diffused air. The same thing happens here. All the air conditioning comes from behind this panel. And it's diffused into the atmosphere so you don't feel draft on you. You just feel the coolness of the interior. Okay. The shape of this, you see, is very iconic, very unique. It's got a teardrop shape in the back. But then on this car, we are emphasizing the shapes that are on the wheels to be wheel forms. So it's not a drag body side. And as we go around the back of the car, you can see something very iconic. This, as Steve pointed out on the first part, we had the Volvo shape that comes from the P1800 ES. This is a shape, an iconic shape that we started on the ECC, S80, S60. We're identifying an iconic thing that we hope the customer can identify as well. Very identifiable in the back end. So this is like a little station wagon that's very, very sporty. Isn't it fun though?
This is.
I'd love to have one of these. And we built 12 of these models before we built this. We chose the most conservative one to pull in the full size. So look out for the future. Okay?
We have a problem with the power as well.
Oh, here. We'll do that. Oh, okay. Here we go. The door is open uniquely here. And this is not the final operation of how the door opens, but what we're saying is if you have a large door, we don't want to swing it open in the normal fashion. We want to undulate it in such a way that it's easy to get in and out. And when you look at this door panel on the inside, you'll see how uniquely it's designed. There's light around it. There's a grab. Wherever you want to grab the door, you can grab it. The same thing is true with this car as what's true in the first car. There's a normal seating position so that you've got great vision, and the seat will adjust in that aspect. A lot of the outside comes to the inside. This is all carbon fiber on the inside. But the carbon fiber that we use on the inside is a flexible carbon fiber, so that it doesn't shear when it breaks. We also have carbon fiber coming from the hood. It also comes to the inside on the dash, and then goes underneath, and then it becomes a little unit down below where you turn the key on. And as this works, we just push a button here, and our power is not on. Yeah. This morning it worked beautifully. Okay. And Stefan here, he's going to hook it up.
There, now you can see that.
Here's the lighting.
The light in the doors. To give different ambient, different colors coming through.
Remember 2001 Space Odyssey? How everything was white? Our color and trim expert, Alexis Center, she said we've got to bring some of this whiteness into our cars. And the new adventure in interiors is white. And so we're using the ceramic white. This is like a corium white. We're using that in the car, not only in design, but when you put light with it, it just gives you this ambient feeling that is just, it's really fun. It's really great. Let's see if this works now. Here's the interior moving forward. Moves forward 200 mil, and that allows you to get in the back seat easier. And also to move that direction. Now, in order to move this carriage forward on impact, we worked with two universities to develop this shock absorber. And the shock absorbers actually came from the R that we have, our R racing model. And the uniqueness of these shock absorbers is that they will work within 2 milliseconds. They will adjust. And the sensors actually come from the restraint system. What you feel in the restraint system also senses in the seat, and it'll adjust to how quickly it moves.
So they stiffen up when you?
Yeah, it moves the carriage.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because it starts to move it. Because in this moves very, when it's on impact, it moves very quickly. Yeah, and if it's a big acceleration, you have to also accelerate it just as fast. So it has to compensate with the right amount of initial energy, inertia in both directions. And that was developed by two universities, one in Chalmers here, and then one in Leuna, am I pronouncing that right? Another where? University here in Sweden.
What's the second one?
Luia.
Up north, you mean?
I think so.
Luleå.
And so that was kind of a fun project also for those guys. But we think this is an answer to, especially California, because if you want to drive a car that's small, you also want to have a safe car. Yeah, I do, I know. And I know if I have important package, you know, like my wife or my children, I want them to be absolutely safe. And I think you can go in style if you're in this car.
Okay, that's the next one. Okay.